Stream. This podcast will be live and archived into YouTube. This is Green Beans, YouTube Berto 25G. And I will be doing a broadcast on team builds, tips, and tricks. So if you're new, hop on and ask me some questions. If you don't catch the live broadcast, send a comment below on the YouTube. I'm in the guild Santa's Big Gifts, third in the world on PS4. We should be taking on Fire Chaos Style this week and competing for first by the end of the week. We're only 2,300 trophies away from second, so we should be able to get that in a few days. So by the end of the week, we should be close to 60,000 trophies. So if Pew Pew doesn't keep it up, we'll be catching them quicker than that. So you can see the leaderboards. A lot of guilds have been active. Wolfpack has been working their way to stay on up in the top. Misguided Misfits had jumped up there into fourth place. They're doing pretty good. Stone Vengeance, they've kind of slowed down. Everybody's kind of aggressively playing, and they were neck and neck with Wolfpack, and now Misguided Misfits is just jumping and taking the score. Moshi Monsters, they're coming from 7th to 6th, so they're doing pretty good. But that's because there's a glitch right here saying that Wolfpack is also 3rd place, so that's a glitch. Everybody is actually down one. Got Freedom Fighters, Duel Masters, England, and Heroes Legendaries. Those are the top 10. Laughing Dead is gone. They're done. So these are the top 10, and we will be top 2 by the end of this week. Right. Let's look at some of my teams right here. I've kind of, you can see the names of them. They're not really representing for who they really are, because I have a glitch on here that I cannot go past the 8th team or the game will crash. So once I get past this giant team, the game will crash and close the application. I sent a error report and video that is still going on, so I'm having to redo my teams. Even though they have another name on them, I'm having to redo them. The first team I'm gonna be working with is, it says Brown Mana, but it's not really Brown Mana. This is a defense Rowan team. It's mainly focused on Rowan and her attack that does 10 damage and splits among enemies boosted by armor with a 2 time boost ratio, which is really good. So it does 2 times 12 to 24 on top of the 10, which is 34 split among all the enemies. So 34 damage in one shot is pretty good, and less enemies is more damage. That's without any additional armor. Alistar, I'm using him. He gives all allies 9 armor and removes purples to boost the effect and gains a barrier. I use him on the top because he gains barriers and the skull damage neglects the attack. It's 3-to-1 boost ratio for every purple will add to the 9 armor. So it'll automatically give Rowan 9 armor on top of his 12 and the boost ratio as well. These are my mana generators. Green's here, just a new troop from last week. Transform select mana color into green and tangle a random enemy. This is a really good one. Most of those mana generators just do one effect. This one does the transforms into green and entangles an enemy, which is awesome if he entangles the first troop, which will neglect his skull damage. I also have Volcare, however you pronounce it. Transform a selected mana color to blue and gain 7 souls. And that one is powering Alistar. And the green seer is powering Rowan. The traits I have, I only have them for these guys. Fey Bond, 2 life for all Feys. Blessed, all allies gain 2 random skill points. That is one of the best ones I like. If you can get a team with this trait and just have them stack on top of each other, that would be awesome if they, I mean, it's a 1 in 4 chance that it gains on your magic, so it's either your magic, your attack, your armor, or your life. So the magic is the one that you want. Attack is good if you have lots of skulls. And for here, I have a Divine Bond. Start of the battle, divines gain 2 life. Necromancy. Gain 50% bonus souls at the end of the battle, which is really good. That'll tack onto your bonuses, so 50%, and plus 7 souls every time you earn every game. So I have it named Brown Mana. It's not really Brown Mana. And my team bonus is Lord of Thorns, having 2 unique Force of Thorns troops. That's all I have right now. The team bonus, but that's the one I will be using right now. Let's go ahead and jump into a PvP, see how this works. Two trophies, Michael. Behemoth, Boar Rider, Stargazer, and Atlanta. Purple and yellow is his. So let's go ahead and change teams. I'll show you that team later. And this game has a lag when you're selecting teams, so you're gonna have to bear with me. All right. So it looks like the skill went towards the attacks on everybody. The blessed skill point gave everybody a bonus attacks. It's pretty good. I'd rather be the magic, but it's fine. All right, the first thing I want to do is go for, well, I can go for anything right now. I can go for reds, greens, purples and yellows. I think I want to focus on yellows and blues and reds.
Divine strength watch over us.
That behemoth is super strong. I do not want him to get skulls. Right now we're playing offense while we get our teams together. We've got nothing. I want to get
Mana
let's
surge.
work on Alistar. Cause that behemoth could wreck us. 8 damage. Got a good amount of purples. We got 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 10. Got 10 purples here.
Mana surge.
got rid of that behemoth too. And he takes away... No, he didn't take away any purple. Well, added more purples. Mana surge. There we go, good. He didn't take away any of the purples, so we've got more purples. So 9 armor, the 3-to-1 boost ratio for all the purples. Mana added surge. 14 armor and a barrier. Now I'm gonna work on Rowan. Let's go for the yellow. Mana surge. And I got the greens here ready to go. What I like to do with my mana conversers, I like to make them where they have an extra turn. So I'm gonna look right here. I have an extra turn if I turn the blues into greens. Let's go ahead and do that. From the life of the earth. Mana surge, mana surge. Alright. So that's Rowan's ready. He's got 27 armor, 10 damage on top of that. Boosted by his armor's 2-to-1 ratio. So that's gonna do a lot. Let's say 50 plus 10, 60 damage. 60 damage. That should wipe him out, if not leave him with like one life. No, it gave 30 just one person. Okay. The barrier worked pretty good. And their troop has 0 attack because of the entanglement. That's awesome. So I want to go ahead and get Rowan up again. So let's work on our blues, greens, and purples, and yellows. Now let's just put some more armor while we can. Mana surge. My land is gonna hit us hard, so might as well. 9 damage. Green and blue. Green. No one shall escape my arrow. Here we go. This is for the knockout. Mana surge. Times 2. Need a lady scream. Alright, let's see how many souls he's generated from this too. 2 trophies. Minor magic. 3 glory. 1209 souls. That's not much, but I'm playing on default. So that's that team. Let's move over to the Gloomleaf team. This one's going to focus on Gloomleaf and Orion as far as attacks. Gloomleaf steals 4 armors and 2 attacks. That's a level 19 legendary. Got no traits on him yet. Green Seer, you've just seen that one. That's gonna boost my Gloomleaf, get him going. Alchemist, level 15. And he transforms a selected mana into yellow and gain 13 gold. So, he's gonna generate my yellows. Merchant, 25% bonus gold at the end of the battle. And Orion, level 19 legendary. Deal 3 to 25 damage to an enemy, place Hunter's Mark, gain 5 magic. So everyone is gonna gain 5 magic. No traits for him. Alright, and I've got focus on green and yellow as far as the mana. Got two bonuses, Lord of Thorns and Fae Captain. So 1+ magic, that's good. Armor and life, that's fine, but magic is the key here. So that's gonna help Gloomleaf. When he steals 4 and 2, he can do more than that. You know what? I'm actually gonna retreat a game so I don't get a bonus on my stars. I wanna spread out my stars so I can get more trophies for my team. We are a very competitive guild, so we have to do a lot of work. So I'm gonna focus on trophies as well. What's the name? So I'm gonna go ahead and retreat this, so I can replace these revenges with 2 trophies. This is from the last one. Alright, 600 gold. Let's try something a little more valuable. There we go, 1,000. Well, I didn't even get to see his team. Alright, Gloomleaf, Alchemist, go yellow. You get bonus mana. Mana surge. Mana surge. And if I do this, I can get blues. Blues don't do anything, but I can hit them with skulls too. Alright, looks like I can get brown ready to go. Here's an extra turn if I can drop those reds. I can't, though. Alright. Let's get Alchemist going. Surge. Skulls on the board. Alright. Yellows. We're looking for an extra turn with the yellow. So we have yellow and purple. Let's do that. Mana surge. Mana Orion's surge. Ready to go. Got lots of skulls though. Could turn the greens into yellows. And that will give me an extra turn and Gloomleaf. From the life of the earth. Mana surge. Mana surge. Mana surge. Mana surge. Hey PJ, welcome to my stream. I'm streaming Gems of War today. If you haven't already played this game yet, you should definitely download it. It's free. I'm showing out my team builds. This is my Gloomleaf team build. Illuminati confirmed. Alright, so I got a bonus magic for my Gloomleaf, so he's going to be stealing 5 armor, which will give him additional 15, and yeah, you should definitely play it. So, I'll give him 20 armor. And 6 additional attack. And let's see. Let's go ahead and hit Orion up. I will cut you down. Hit him and put a hunter's mark on him. But he's already dead. Mana
surge.
Alright, now I want to turn the browns into greens, get an extra turn.
From the life of the earth.
Mana surge.
And I got both of these enemies are entangled, which is great.
Mana surge.
They're pretty much done, but let me go ahead and boost Gloomleaf again. Damage there. Alright, yellows, extra turn. We want purple. Let's go for purple.
Mana surge.
Finish him off with Orion.
I will cut you.
See our spoils. Six souls and a treasure map. Nice. 48 souls. That's pretty good. And I got all these tasks here, which I need to get them accomplished. Let's go ahead and forge a trait. To this guy. Two gem keys. Four troops of the same mana. And arena. Really don't like doing arena. Just feel like it's a waste of time. Alright. Let's look at our next team. Goblin team. This composes of level 20 goblin, 15 damage, greedy trait, 2 bonus gold, human slayers does double skull damage, boar rider, level 20, 17 damage, beast bond, all the beasts gain 2 life, PvP, 3 plus armor, and 1 plus magic for each green ally. All my allies are green, so it's gonna give him 18 magic, which will give him 20 damage. Another goblin, and a goblin king, 5 life, summon a level 10 goblin. No traits for him. Let me go ahead and retreat a battle so I don't get a bonus star. That's weird looking team. Yeah, I got it. I'm in a guild. I am in a pretty prestigious guild. Santa's Big Gifts. I don't know if you heard of us. We're a third. And check that out. I'll be right back. Thank you. right now. But our guild leader, I don't know if you can hear me. Our guild leader rotates some of the weaker clan members. So if you want to join, you have to contact our guild leader, Claw Santa 86. But it's a very competitive guild. We used to be part of Pew Pew. I met Santa when I joined Pew Pew, and Santa was the main contributor to Pew Pew, one of the main contributors in trophies and gold. And the leader from Pew Pew was inactive and didn't give over leadership to Santa. And Pew Pew was had a bunch of inactive troops, so the leader could not. Oh, you're a low level? Yeah, that's. Well, I mean, the thing is, you gotta get the trophies. That's the main thing, because we're trying to get the first. And you gotta get over 100 trophies a week. It's qualifications. He recommends that you're level 100, but over 100 trophies. We try to go around, shoot for 200 trophies a week. So Santa left Pew Pew and started a new guild. Maybe 6 weeks ago. And a lot of us from Pew Pew left. So this is a 6 week old guild. I'm not gonna do a party chat for this broadcast. I probably will for Don't Starve though. I'll do Don't Starve if I don't get short on time. So we focus on contributing. Someone's already contributed. So our guild is active in donating gold and completing trophies. So if you see our activity, we're constantly donating in trophies. And as you saw before, I didn't have many glory chest keys. We just keep them coming. So we probably get about, ooh, new Hobgoblin. That's a new troop for today, this week. If you haven't already got him yet, he's in the store, the reward store, Hobgoblin. We probably get about 100 glory keys a day or more. Great guild. All right, back to the teams. If somebody was 1,000 gold bounty. Oh, that's nice. 1,200 dragons. All right. We're gonna change up our team to the Goblin team. Have to wait for this lag, of course. There we go. Take on the dragons. So all my stats have been boosted. Let's see, 21 damage. That's nice. And My goblins have 22 attack, 23. So we're well over this level 19s. These are some, you know, some really good troops that they have on their team, but thanks to the patch, mine are pretty much better than their legendaries. The goblin is a common troop, and now he's a divine troop, or whatever you call this. Epic? No, not epic. Divine.
Mana surge.
So with two turns, I already got three troops ready to go.
Mana surge.
Alright, let's get our Boar and Gore ready to go. I usually like to do something where I can get another move in. Let's just do this. Kill the Gorgatha. So I just did 4 attacks in one turn. Because the goblins, extra turns. That's what I love about the goblins, their extra turns. Focus on greens and purples.
Mana surge.
Extra turn down there. And we got a green pair.
Mana surge.
Okay, let's go ahead and do that again. See, we got an extra turn right here with this blues. Go ahead and use this goblin. Knock out that sugar.
Surge.
Got an extra turn there. Gonna go ahead and knock him out.
Mana surge.
And there. Hit sugar up. Bonus that purple. Another one of the skulls. Take my purples. Take a yellow.
Mana surge.
There we go. And I got a Goblin King ready.
Mana surge.
But it's already over, I think.
Mana surge.
Nice. And I can remove a chosen color. So I'm gonna remove the yellow, because there's a lot of them. Wow. Gave him a lot of life, but didn't do anything. Jeez. Oh, I was hoping the greens would line up.
Mana surge. Mana surge.
That level 10 goblin's pretty weak.
Mana surge. Mana surge.
And that's it. Goblin team. 2,000 gold. Okay. Now let's look at another team build. Let's see what this one. This one was part of a task. Oh, my knights. Let's check out my knights. My knights are awesome. I can't wait to get a trait for my cornet knight. He's got to be one of my super strongest. To wait for this lag. There we go. The blue knights. Got two cornet knights, which are level 20. Got a 12 magic with 13 damage to first and last enemies. Removes all purples to boost. So he does 13 damage to the first and last. So that's a total of 26. Combined, and then boost 2-to-1 ratio for all the purples removed. So that's on top of the 13. So he could do a lot of damage. We've got the leader trait, 3 to all stats in first position, which I have in first. And water spirit, gain 1 magic for every blue. All of them are blue, so it's 3 magic and 3. So that's 6 magic on top of what he's already got. So he's going to have 18 magic, which will be 19 damage to the first two the first and last. 19 damage is a lot for two people, not including the boost of the purples. So this is a guy you're going to want to have on your team. This is definitely a team you should try out. Got two of them. A Griffin Knight, level 20. He does 17 magic, so he has 21 damage to a random enemy. Which is not really random because you get to choose it. I think it's a glitch. Create 7 yellow gems, which will boost my Knight Cornet. He's immune to Entangle. Gains 1 magic for every blue. And 25% reduction from Skulls, which... he shouldn't get hit with Skulls, he's a third troop. So, that's him, he's pretty good. I mean, he's only 9 for the mana. These guys are 12. Lance Knight, which I really don't get to use him much because my Cornet Knights really do the bulk of the damage. He's level 15. I just pretty much use him for the team bonus and the magic bonus with the blue. Destroyer roll, gain 8 armor boosted by all green with a 2x ratio for all greens destroyed. Knights, all ally knights gain 2 life. And bonus blue mana for blue matches. So he's giving me bonus blue on top of my banner, which gives me 1 bonus blue as well. So I'll be getting 2 bonus blues every time I match a blue, and 1 bonus yellow. I get a Master of Water, 25%, plus 25 to my Water Mastery, which is over 100. And that's for having all blues. King of the Blades, 10 plus armor, which is a lot, for all troops. For having 4 unique Swords Edge troops, and Knight General for having 2 attack and 4 armor for having 4 unique Knight troops. There's a glitch in the game right now where the first troop can be duplicated with any of the third, 1 through 3rd. But if I were to rotate, if I were to rotate this guy with this guy, I would lose that bonus. So that's just a cool glitch that you can keep in mind. Is you can have duplicates of the first 1 to the 2nd, the 3rd, or 4th. But you cannot have duplicates in the 3rd, 2nd, 3rd, or 4th to get a bonus, team bonus. So, I have only 3 different troops, but it's picking up as if I had 4 different troops. So, this might also work in your task as well. So, if you have 2 of the same troops, you want to use 2 of the same troops, make sure one of them is in the first slot. And you'll get an extra team bonus. Let's try this bad boy out. This is a really good team. Sorry, Shorty, you're too cheap. Two trophies? Alright, we'll do you. Like he's all over the place, focusing on blue and brown. Let's load up our blue knight scene. After we wait for this delay. For changing teams, they need to fix it. It's gotten a lot better than it used to be, but it's still horrible. All right, let's battle. So here we go, gaining all of our magic, healths, and armors. So now we got 20 damage. The first and last. That's a lot. 17. 25 damage. And I'm not even going to get to use him. But I will use his water leak bonus. Alright, right off the bat, I'm going for blues.
Mana and yellows.
I gave him double.
Mana surge.
Next turn. That sucked. Extra turn.
Mana surge.
Even though I just took away a bunch of purple, so. Let's hit him up with some skulls. There we go. Extra turn. And you know what? Let me go ahead and charge that other guy up. We could probably just finish the whole team with these two guys right here. Blue and yellow. Nothing. And that's because he hasn't upgraded. It's still super rare.
Mana surge.
Look at that. Bonus mana. Three damage. That's not gonna kill them. But it'll hurt them a lot.
Mana surge. Mana surge.
Hopefully he creates me some yellows and doesn't get a match. He didn't use it. 15 damage, what does mine do? 25. Mine does 10 more damage than his. And that's because he hasn't upgraded. It's still super rare.
Mana surge.
Look at that. Bonus mana. Well, didn't get an extra turn. I did. Kill Atlanta right now. Oh, it's over. And that's my Blue Knight team. Pretty epic build. I'm very proud of that one. definitely give that one a try. Let's see. I got defeated by one. It's pretty decent. I'm gonna go ahead and retreat from him so I don't get my bonus 2 stars. And what I'm doing here is I'm using this. This is my silent one. He's one of my weakest troops. He's only level 1. I'm using him for defender. If I do that, I'll get a lot of revenges. Hopefully I can get a really good revenge. Helps out in the trophies. Get somebody with 1,000 gold. That's close enough.
Mana Surge.
Took all my yellows and blues. Let's look for browns. No browns. Don't want to take purples. Well, I do want to take, I don't want him to use that attack on me.
Mana Surge.
Which would suck, because I have 42 armor. And that would definitely kill him. And probably kill him as well. That one move, that bone dragon. Gotta get rid of him. Gotta get rid of him. And he's out of Cerberus. This is a pretty good team. Really offensive. Definitely working on the offense. I can just get some good colors in here. That'd be great. Got rid of him. But I gotta get rid of that Cerberus. 25% to devour, and my troops have really good stats, so I do not want him to get him. I don't know why it wants me to get red.
Mana Surge.
Thank you very much, sir. Let's get a bit of purples on there. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. That'd be a 4 bonus. 24 damage. Blues and yellows.
Mana Surge.
Oh. Easy. And this is overkill. It'll do over 40 damage. He's only got 5 guys. $1,800. Let me go back to that Rowan Alistar team. Secret Hobo. A little bit more gold out of here. Oh no. One trophy and 300 gold. Let's try that Rowan Alistar team. After we wait for this thing to load up. If you have any questions, be sure to comment. Like I said, I got lots of tips and tricks, and if you got your own team build you want to see, I can do it right in front of you. Which one is that? It's green and yellow? No, it was blue and yellow. So I'm gonna go ahead and get my green tier ready.
Mana surge.
And some skull damage. Got lots of skulls. This looks like a skull battle here. Alright, turn these reds into greens. Next turn.
Mana surge. Mana surge.
Lots of skulls. I can't believe all these skulls I'm getting. See if we can get an extra turn here, though. Nope. Okay.
Take that.
That wasn't bad.
Mana surge.
Let's try it again. Got extra turn. Let's see. No extra turns. Skulls. Let's do the skulls.
Mana surge.
That one rockworm's doing him pretty well. I love rockworms. They seem to be my favorite troop. Alright, let's see. Green. No extra turns. Ooh. Burn, poison. Oh, he didn't entangle him. Oh, he replaced the. What is it? Burn and poison. He used to entangle him. So instead of a triple bite, it's a double bite. Okay. Well, let's turn the reds into green.
From the life of the earth.
Mana surge.
And oh, I didn't have enough to do it.
Mana surge.
There we go. Now let's just finish it off. No, I think I have 10 life. No longer on fire.
Surge.
Oh, he's taking my armor. So I'm not even gonna.
From the life of the earth.
Mana Surge. Mana Surge.
Too much damage to him. That's why I needed Alistar. So right off the bat, Alistar is the one you're gonna wanna go for. To get that barrier and armor. Try one more team build here. I'm gonna use the rockworms and acolytes. See, I used the glitch with the first place. So saying I have two unique Kazazel troops. Let me go ahead and check out who's all in Kazazel. Okay, Regatta. Deep Boar. Oh, I think the game just crashed. Okay, no it didn't. Kazazel. Two, three unique. Okay, I got three unique Kazazel. Let me go back to that rockworm. Alright. This is one of my original teams that I've built when I first started. So it's a great beginner team. Because I have three rockworms, which are a common troop. Let's see what we got here. So let's go ahead. Oh, I didn't change the team. My bad. Let me go ahead and retreat anyways, because I don't want to get a bonus star. And I believe that was the first team. Let's wait for this loadout time. It's taken a very long time. There we go. This will be my last battle, and I'm gonna end the broadcast after this. So if you got any more questions, you might want to ask them now, and add me as a friend if you want. Check out my other videos. Follow me on Twitch and subscribe to the YouTube. So I'm focusing on Rockworm and Acolyte. Level 20. 9 brown gems and increase random skill by 8. Also have Stone Link, which gives me bonus brown mana, and Curse, which loses 2 random skills from the enemy's team. I got Stoneheart, 1 bonus life, and 1 bonus magic for each brown, so I've got 3 browns. So, he's increased his magic, so he does 18 damage, and creates 7 brown gems. Go ahead and do that.
Mana Surge. Strange.
I'll take his reds.
Mana Surge. Mana Surge.
Oh, look at that purple. Yeah.
Mana Surge. Mana
oh,
Surge.
God. Lucky, lucky, lucky. And he's got another set of skulls. Okay. Now let's create some browns. Increase my attack. Fourteen damage. And 14 armor. That's pretty good. Get some extra turns out of this. Come on.
Mana
there we
surge.
Go. Everybody's ready to roll.
Mana surge.
And you just chain off of this over and over with this rock worm. Rock worms are so OP.
Mana surge.
Never ending. Turns pretty much the rock worms.
Mana surge, mana surge, mana surge.
And there you go. Surge. Non-stop chains with the rock worms. Surge. So if you're new, I would definitely recommend the rock worms and the colite combo. Thanks for watching. Like I said, be sure to subscribe. Follow me on Twitch. Subscribe to my YouTube. Thank you.